Hi, good morning. Welcome to my channel. I am Thomas Sim, EA2066. Today is 27 January 2023. I'd like to do a recording on CPD requirement for estate agency practice. Let me begin. Hi, welcome to my channel. What is required by CPD for estate agents? CPD for renewal of authority to practice. I'm Thomas Sim, PA2066. Today is 27 January 2023. So our reference point will be the guideline which is published by the board. So the one that I have in hand, which is the earlier one in the hard copy, the edition, second edition, which now replaced by the third edition. So the second edition, which I have hard copy, is in blue. Let me show you. Right, continuing professional development, CPD. So this is for the registered estate agent. The other one is called the CDP. People get confused with CPD and CDP. The CDP is continuous development program. So this continuous, I do not know why they use the continuous instead of continuing. So it can be continuing development program or it can be continuous development program. Probably is interchangeably used as well. But the difference is this CDP is for the real estate negotiator, the REN, not for the REA. So the REA, it is continuing professional development, and for the REN is called continuous development program. The main difference between these two is that the apart from being a requirement for REA in the law and not be mentioned as in the case for the REN, the REN CDP program is only a once in a year event to be attended. So it's a half day, a bit more than half day event, which is organized by the board for the purpose of renewal of the rent tag every year. So this CDP is actually different in the sense that it has no point system, but only a single event to be attended as a requirement of the renewal of the rent tag. It's only a specialized prepared event on a half day, like roughly about morning 9 o'clock to about 1 p.m. And this program is only organized for the purpose of the renewal. So this is the different CPD, the continuing professional program, is a point system for the purpose of the registrant. Now in this case, not just for registered estate agent, but for all the registrant, valuer, and also the property managers who are registered with the board to accumulate a certain point system to qualify for their annual practicing renewal. So this annual practicing renewal is in a point system. Talking about a profession like a medical doctor, and a medical doctor, they have the continual program called the CME point, or continual medical education. And this point system is to be collected per year at a certain amount of point to submit for the annual renewal of the practicing certificate. So the same is applied to nursing, also for pharmacists, the professional CME point. So this system of CPD for the registered estate agent is registered estate agent in Malaysia has to submit their point when they are year-end renewal for annual practicing certificate. So this is the third edition 2017. The wordings is guidelines on continuing professional development CPD for registered valuers, appraisers, and estate agents. Of course, here it would include also the property managers. As in 2018, the law has already included property managers. So the earlier edition, the second edition, is 2005. So the notification I like to share with you is that the recent changes also due to COVID has come up with certain changes, and the notification as I can get back to in 2022 is that the PEA probationers, probationary estate agents are now required to follow this CPD for the purpose of their renewal. In the earlier years, before 2002 notification until now, there is no need for a probationary estate agent on a renewal of their probationary status to have any particular CPD point. So now they are implementing this starting from 2023 renewal to 2024. So I can put it as effectively 2024 renewal. So if you want to renew your probational registration 2024, then you have to accumulate a certain point system of CPD in the year 2023, or else you cannot renew your probationary estate agent registration. So this is in particular interesting for a new change for CPD for the PEA. So now we continue on. So on the 5th of August 2022, the board came up with a notification saying that the authority to practice for valuer, appraiser, estate agent and property managers would require the CPD point, which is built back to the earlier years in the guideline as in 10 CPD point. Then the probationers status has to renew with five CPD points. So the earlier system of a probationary agent, no need to register CPD point is on the context that because probationers are under training, so all the time they are doing CPD. In fact, all the work is supposed to be doing all the continual education. Whereas now the interpretation is some of the probationers are actually totally out of the field. They are not doing anything about the state agency, and yet they want to come back to the profession. So for the more stringent control, for the more professional way of saying that they are in the job, they should be always back to practice or always back to education. So that is the likely reason that CPD now is imposed on the professionals. And 5 CPD points to behalf of the registered estate agent. The main purpose later on we would explore what is the reason of why CPD is been imposed on professional practice like registered estate agent. We continue so here the box out on the validity of probationary status for probationers. So now it's saying that if you do not have the CPD point, then you cannot renew. And a probationer who has been suspended from practice by the board shall be required to submit also the 5 CPD, because some of the probationers, they never renew when they forgot to renew by year end. The following year they can still renew, but they are under suspension. So when the suspension professionals wants to come back, they have to pay penalty for the registration which has lapsed. And then also now this group also will be included to have the CPD point before they can apply back as a professional. So CPD point for 5 CPD point is important for each and every probationer to continue their registration, and for those who did not have registration or being suspended, they have to get their CPD point fulfilled and to resubmit for renewal or for continuing or to apply to come back as a probationer. So now there is a new guideline on continuing probationer at development 2022, which is the 4th edition. So now the latest edition would be the 4th edition, not the 3rd edition, but I think the changes is roughly about the same, which is similar to what is been issued in the circular. The renewal for the 2024, would have to implement all these new guideline for probationer to have the 5 CPD point in 2024. So PA having CPD now is been mentioned already issued in the notification as well as in the new guideline. So 2024, a key milestone on the change in the system that CPD will be implemented for probationer. So we have also another notification by the board on the September 5th, 2022. And this roughly talk about the same thing which has been agreed upon in the third edition already, which is below 55 years old registered estate agent or registered valuer, registered appraiser or registered property managers, the requirement is 10 CPD points. However, those who are 55 to 60 years old, that means when a person is 55, the zero debt on the 55 years above until 59 years and 11 months and 30 days, these groups would have to submit the 5 CPD point, so that's half similar to the probationer. And those who are achieving 60 years of age and above do not require CPD point. All these are in the guideline of the CPD guideline, right? So that just to repeat again, 10 points for those who are young, 55 and above until 59 and before touching 60 year old is half, and then the one that is 60 years and above is zero CPD point. So during the COVID-19 time, which is the circular 20/2020, because the whole 2019 and until the whole year 2020, even until 2021, there were not enough events. That means a lot of things are shut down, and there is a reason that because of COVID, MCO happened, and conditional MCO, recovery MCO. During this period of time, they cannot have a physical meeting. All these CPD and the CDP cannot be held online. So all these CPD and CDP cannot be held online means they cannot be enough points for them to renew. So during this period, the board came out with a more lenient way, reduction of the CPD hours for renewal of the authority to practice. This been cut down from 10 to 5. Those who are supposed to accumulate 10 points now only need 5 points, whereas those who are 5 points only need to do 2 points, 2 CPD hours. So now no more already. This is all. In fact, for 2021 renewal to 2022, in fact, there were some already not following this. And then 2022 to 2023 is basically going back to 10 CPD point. And in the future, unless anything happen again, they will be back to the same old 10 CPD point. So the reason of why CPD is actually given the power by the Act under Section 16 of the Valuer Appraiser Estate Agents and Property Managers Act 1981. The board is empowered to impose conditions for the annual renewal of the annual certificate, which is the authority to practice. Authority to practice by Section 16 by firm. Practice by firm, one of the conditions is for the renewal of the authority to practice required to submit for CPD hours. So this is in the rules also. So there are 4 points each for the purpose of continuing professional development. One is for the registrant, and the other one is for the good of the profession. So for the registrant, it is to give them opportunity to continuing their education, to do their knowledge and skills, to enhance their practice, to improve their quality of service to their client, and to develop the professional competence to revise and also revisit those areas of body of knowledge that the registrant is doing in practice every day, and also to reduce their risk of negligence and also professional liabilities, because there are changes in the law and the regulation. Like for example, we have the AMLA, CFT, those called Counter Financial Terrorism Act, which is now being zoomed into registered estate agents practice. So all these compliance to the law and monitored by Bank Negara Malaysia. Also, there are changes in the law that governs the loan disbursement. There are changes also in the registration of businesses in the Companies Act. And then also there are changes in the property taxation, like RPGT changes, stamp duty changes. All these are area where a registered estate agent should be competent enough to advise the client. So these are the reasons for the purpose of continuing the professional development. And then also for the profession, if a profession doesn't move forward, it's also a problem for the profession, because the profession need to safeguard the rights of the clients, people who are stakeholder. So if earlier on the example just now, the stamp duty changes, the RPGT changes, the even the withholding tax changes also, the stakeholder like negotiator also need to hold the you need to hold the 2% of the professional fee to pay to the inland revenue. If you do not follow all these things, then there will be penalty in the law. So for the good reason of the profession to safeguard higher profile of the vacation, higher practice level, clearer professional identity that we are involved in this job, higher skilled registrant, and also enhanced professional ethics. So there are rules that need to be followed, and therefore these rules keep on changing, and the changing rules would affect the profession. And having this continuing professional development for the members, the registrants, to ensure that registrants also are aware and able to keep up to the changes. The CPD activities which registrant or members can get point system is actually categorized under this so-called 8 category. Most of us will actually attend those seminars, conference, congresses. So these are very common activities that are organized by the associations. Then you have also area where you can earn points by being invited as speaker, or you have a presentation of papers to the above conferences. And there are professional bodies like board. If you are taking part in the board as a board member, or you are taking part in other activities by the different board, RISM is actually a Royal Institute of Surveyors Malaysia, PEPS, MIEA, MIPPM, PIPC, and other related relevant professional meetings. These are meetings like the branch meeting, the directors meeting, and then activity that they are doing for the profession. So these types of involvement in the professional association also earns you CPD point. Also, the other area is more to knowledge learning, so part-time and full-time study at institution or higher learning, practical training with the board. As I say, you are working in a area of law, and then you are now attached to a certain organization, like for example, the bar council. You are at bar council, or you are working with the land office as an attachment. And all these attachments, you can give it to board to be allocated a CPD point. So one of the possibility is that the association can work with these authorities, like land office on the ground, and then our members are attached in the land office to get a CPD point. Research undertaken, informative paper produced, columnist in national papers, article written, journal publication, and professional matters, private study and reading, which you can prove and show it to the board, and board would allocate Later, we will see how much point all these activities will earn you CPD point. Even if you are appointed as a panel of expert or advisor or committee members for the appointment on this institution, you are also able to get CPD point on this. So that's why they say that appendix, you need to refer to appendix, and later we will see the appendix. Also, the main part is usually attending seminar, and these seminars usually will be conducted by the association, and you may be attending it as a participant, or you can be attending as also as speaker. So both as a participant, you earn CPD point, as a speaker, you also earn CPD point. Private study, later we will see a very minimal point, you can earn a very minimal point, but there is a way that it is provided. How about exemption? So if let's say there are conditions that you do not able to have a CPD point and yet you want to renew your authority to practice, there are a few exemptions. Board may grant full or partial exemption for the purpose of below. So the first is 20.1, registrant who have attended the age of 60 years or shall be granted full exemption, no need to have CPD point. One of the possibility in this is that above certain number of years of exposure to the market, they are already quite fixed in the sense that they are aware of the changes. They may be retired as well, and their practice may be not so active. So these types of practice, this type of firm practice may be not so important to know the latest changes. They are in the retirement step. Registrants who are 55 and above will require a minimum of 5 CPD points. So this one, as we said just now, those who are below 55, they need to have 10 CPD points. Those are above 55, but less than 60 years old, only half 5 CPD points. Those are above 60 years old, no need any CPD points. Any person who is practicing under special authority, not exceeding 1 year, no need to have CPD point. Registrants who are suffering from severe ailment, like probably some of the senior age also, or maybe some of the younger ones who already have certain severe ailment like cancer. So this group of registrants or stroke, this group of registrants, not convenient for them to attend these classes. Of course, it's not very common that you hear this type of situation, but you do have during the COVID time, some senior members suffered from COVID, and the disease has made them unable to perform the normal level of activity. So registrants who are full-time study leave, or these are the cases where they are full-time study leave, they are not practicing on the ground. So they probably do a postgraduate degree, and therefore in this scenario, they are not practicing. Registrants who have been granted exemption from the board. So if there are those who are other reasons, they can go back to the board and the board will say, okay, no need for you because in this scenario, you are exempted. So only under this exemption that a registrant do not need to have CPD or less CPD for them to renew the annual practicing certificate, or in this case, the authority to practice. So if you are under the condition of less than 1 year, you are under severe illness or already on a full-time study, not practicing on the ground, and then you are granted exemption. Basis of approval for CPD activities. So in this case of how to count, how to come up with the CPD hours, actually is by this. By CPD hour, it means that the rally on the delivery of the knowledge. So if you have an event which is talking about, say for example, new changes in the law, and then you got a lawyer to come and speak on the law subject. The topic is about 3 hours, let's say. So the maximum time that you sit down and listen to the delivery of his speech if it is only 2 hours and then another hour is tea time or mingle or get together or whatever other activities, then this CPD point will be given as 2 hour serious knowledge learning. That would be 2 CPD point. So 1 CPD hour accrued for each hour spent directly on the CPD activity, subject to the maximum of 5 credit hours per day. So of course, if you got one lawyer talking about new laws, and then later on in the afternoon you have another topic on, say, changes in the taxes by a tax authority from the Inland Revenue on PGT changes, then the 2 speakers delivers on that particular 2 topics would earn the whole day probably maximum 4 credit hour points, 4 CPD points. Some may get approved for 5 CPD points, so it depends on the speaker, the level of the speaker, as well as the approval committee. So credit hours are calculated also to the nearest half hour, so it can be half point, so that 0.5 point for the particular speaker, because his level of knowledge may not be as much as being authority in the field, so in that sense maybe given the 0.5 point. And then it should be excluded the meals, refreshment breaks, question and answer, and also welcoming speech. So sometimes the event, the whole day, only 3 real hours are sitting hours for real delivery of the talk. Maybe 1 hour in the first session, and then the other hour in the second session, and then after lunch another hour, which is the third session. So only 3 heavy hours, and then the rest are not. So that means the maximum point that can be given is probably that day is 3.5. So the 0.5 may be given because of another talk which is not so heavy. So we also see the 0.5 point during later the appendix, because the appendix talks about all this activity carried out by association. So if you take part in the association meetings, then you see the half point.